Welcome to Candle of Joy Ministry online service. I'm glad that you are here and I trust the Lord God you will be blessed today. So the message of today is making a decision. Make the right decision. Now, children of God, we need to understand that the life that we are facing, the life that we are going through, we are facing with a situation, event, where we have to make a decision. We have to take decision. So we are faced with so many choices in this life. Now, for example, you decide to go to the restaurant. And you stare at the menu for 15, 20 minutes. Meanwhile, you've been going to the same restaurant for practically 10, 20 years. And it's still the same menu. It haven't changed. But every time you go over there, you're still flipping that menu. Keep looking at it. Keep staring at it. Why? Because it's hard for you to make a choice. So what we need to understand that in this life, we have some major decision and we have some minor decision. So it depends on people. For me, a major decision is when it comes, for example, to marriage, your academics, and your career. Minor decision maybe is which suits should I wear, which tie should I wear. But for some people, wearing clothes to choose is a major decision. So it's up to people. Now, what we need also to understand, God created us as a moral free agent. God did not create robots. Adam and Eve, they were not robots. So we are made of three parts. We have the spirit, the soul, and the flesh. So we are spirit having a soul and living in the body, which is the flesh. Now, the flesh does what is natural to it and is what? Sin. The spirit is the one that has been made in the image of God, the highest part of man. And that spirit come alive when we accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. And the Holy Spirit now take control of our spirit, start to lead in us. And we have the soul. The soul, that where resides your emotion, that where resides your free will. So we know that the free will comes from the soul. Hallelujah. So children of God, making a right decision, making a good decision. So we have to know that we are faced with many choices in this life. And you have to think carefully before you take any decision. And the fact that you think carefully before you take decision, it makes you responsible of the decision you are making. Now, children of God, you cannot blame God for the consequences of your decision. You can't blame nobody for the consequences of your decision. The choice is always yours. Every decision you make is yours. Whether you decide, God is not to be blamed for the consequences of your action. If you decide right, you get the blessing and you get life. But if your decision are against the word of God, against the will of God for your life, You get what? Frustration. You get what? You get deaf. You get what? So you get curses. So it's up to you to decide. Now, God always make things easy for us. He explains things for us. And he exhorts us, he encourages us to make the right decision. So the way God works with us, with his children, God relates to us based on the decision we are making. God will never force himself on somebody. God will never force a relationship with somebody. God works by the act of persuasion, but God will never force himself onto you. Never. He works with your free will. So at the end of the day, you might receive, you know, some of us, before we make decision, we have counselor, we have people to we talk to, we have friends, and some of us, and some of the people, they're even afraid to make a decision because they don't want to take responsibility. But wherever you seek advice for somebody and you take decision, you have to know, and I want you to know this, you are responsible of the decision. You can hear from people, but you are the decision maker. And since you are the decision maker, you are responsible for everything. You are responsible for consequences. Remember Adam and Eve. When God gave Adam a command and Adam disobeyed, when God now faced Adam, we know the reaction of Adam. It's the woman. He shifts now responsibility. It's the woman. And the woman also, she shifts responsibility. Is the snake. Thank God the snake did not shift responsibility and say, is the monkey or is the gorilla? No, but you see here, they are shifting the blame. But with God, there is no excuse. God punished Adam, Eve, and the serpent. So you take responsibility of your action. You take responsibility of your decision. It doesn't matter who is speaking into your life. You are the decision maker. Now, children of God, in this life, what you need is a decision. What you need is a decision. The way your business is right now, the way your marriage is full of trouble right now, your life is full of crises right now, and it seems as if the devil is winning. For some, it's because of the wrong decision we made. For others, it's because of indecision. So now, children of God, I want you to understand, a decision can move you forward in life. A decision can help you position in order for you to get help from God so you can succeed in this life. So, no action is taken except a decision is first made. You cannot take any action without deciding first. So, decision has to come before you can take an action. You cannot make correction without first taking decision. You have to decide first, then correction can follow. You cannot win a battle without making a decision first. You have to decide that I want to win, then you can go to battle. So children of God, we need to understand that decision can terminate any oppression in your life. Decision can end frustration in your life. Decision can open doors in your life. Decision can break barrier in your life. Decision can make your face to shine. Decision can make your life easier or difficult. It depends on the decision you are making. But you are responsible. And the decision that you are making, this is, it determines the experiences we are going through. So children of God, we need to make a decision. We need to make a decision. Why is it so important for you to make a decision? Why is it so important? You know, some of the decisions that we are making, we are conscious about it, and some we are unconscious. But we are making decisions. You are the sum of the decision you took yesterday. You are the sum of the decision you are making. And don't let somebody else make decision for you. Children of God, why is it so important for us to make decision? Number one, because your decision determines how things turn out for you in life. Your decision determines how things turn out for you in life. Now, let's read here what the Bible says. Let's go in the book of Jeremiah 29 from verse 11 to 13. Jeremiah 29, 11 to 13. Look what the Bible says here. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, when ye shall search for me with all your heart. Now, children of God, it is impossible for you and I to make a decision without a sense of personal destiny. It's impossible for you and I to make decision if we don't know where we are going. Now look here, the Bible is saying that God said the thoughts that I have told you, they are thoughts of good and peace, not of evil, to give you an expected end. Which means that the Lord God has a purpose for your life. Which means that you are not an accident. Which means that you are not here on earth by mistake. But the Lord God brought you here for a purpose. You have to know your purpose here on earth. Once you know your purpose, it will be easier for you to make decisions. Now, the problem is many of us, we don't know our purpose. And that's why we are making decisions, and the decision that we are making turn out to be wrong decision, because we don't have the sense of personal destiny. We don't have the sense. We don't know where we are going. If you do know where we are going, it's easy. Jesus, for example, knew that his purpose was the cross. So every single thing that Jesus was doing was leading to the cross. Hallelujah. Now, children of God, look what the Bible says here. Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. See, children of God, decision. Once you don't know your purpose, once you don't know your purpose, once you don't know what the Lord God already ordained for you, it will be difficult for you to make wise decision. Now look what the Bible says here, Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Look what the Bible says here. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Hallelujah. In all our ways, we should acknowledge him. Acknowledge him as God. Acknowledge him as the one who knows your tomorrow. He knows what is best for you. He knows what is best for you. So he will direct your path. He will counsel you. He will guide you in the decision that you are about to make concerning your life. Why? Because he knows the tomorrow. And the thoughts that he has taught you, they are thoughts of good and peace and not of evil. So you need to lean on God, not lean on your own understanding. Because children of God, some decision, they are major one. Major decision. Especially when it comes, for example, to marriage. For you to make those type of decision, you need to inquire of the Lord God. Because trust me, the person that you meet is not the real one yet. It's just a representative. The woman that you meet, a representative. The man that you meet, a representative. Is the one they want you to, how can I say it? The person that you meet is not the real one. It's the one they want you to know. It's the one they want you to fall in love with. But it's not the real one. You just get married. You will know the real one. So children of God, you need God, for he knows what is best for you. So before making such decision, you need to consult God. And now, children of God, your decision determine how things turn out for you in life. Look, for example, Abraham. God has a purpose for Abraham. God has a vision for Abraham. And God promised him that he will be the father of many nations. And God changed his name from Abram to Abraham. From that moment, Grandpa Abraham should have known that God has a purpose for him. So every decision that he wants to make, every decision that he has to make, the man has to consult God. God promised him a child of promise. But look what happened. When you don't take decision based on your personal destiny, look here, Genesis 16, verse 2. Now look here, Grandpa Abraham. Genesis 16, verse 2. Now we can start with one, Genesis 16, 1. Now Sarai, Abraham's wife, bare him no children, and she had an handmaid, an Egyptian, whose name was Hagar. And Sarai said unto Abram, behold now, the Lord hath restrained me from bearing. I pray thee, go in unto my maid. It might be that I may obtain children by her. And Abram hearkened to the voice of Sarai, his wife. Hallelujah. So the woman now came here and say, look, God promised us, I know, but it's been a long time. I'm too old. I cannot bear a child. So please go into with my housemaid and have a child. And I'm pretty sure Grandpa Abraham, when he heard it, he said, woman, are you sure about what you are saying? She said, yes. Now, he hand up going with the maid, and he had a child with the maid, Ishmael. But Ishmael was not the promise. Ishmael turned out to be the problem. So Grandpa Abraham created a problem by making a wrong decision. He created a problem. And guess what? The promise came later on. Now picture this. You have a destiny. You have a promise from the Lord God, but because you want to take shortcut, because of wrong decision, you end up with a problem before the promise. Now, when the promise comes, you have now the promise and the problem all together. And the problem will fight your promise all your life. And this is what has been going on in the life of many. Why? Because we make bad decisions. It's very important for you to know your purpose. Otherwise, you'll be taking wrong decisions. And children of God, it doesn't matter who advises you. You are the one who's going to live with the consequences because you are the decision maker. And you are the one who's going to pay for it. So children of God, we see here that your decision determines how things turn out for you in life. Number two, you are the one who decides your fate by the decision you make. You are the one who decides your fate by the decision you make. You are the one. Nobody else. Look what the Bible says in John 3:16. For the Lord God loved so much the world, he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him shall be saved, shall have eternal life. God does not force nobody, because God works based on your decision. Either you accept Christ or you don't accept Christ. But he makes it plain for you. This is the benefit of accepting Christ. And these are the consequences of rejecting Christ. But you make that decision. See, the Bible says in the book of Revelation 3:20, the Bible says that God, Jesus, is knocking at the door. It's your decision. It's up to you to open the door or not open the door. It's the decision. So the decision that you are making will decide your fate. Look what the Bible says here, for example, Deuteronomy 30:19. Look here, the Bible. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Deuteronomy 30, verse 19. Look what the Bible says here. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life, that both thou and thy seed might live. Hallelujah. See here, children of God, you are the one who decide your fate by the decision you make. God, he said, I set life and death, but choose. Then he exhorts you, say, choose life. Look here, another example, Joshua 24. Children of God, see here, Joshua 24, and we're going to read verse 13. Joshua 24, verse 13 to 15. Look what the Bible says here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, let's just read Joshua 24, verse 15. And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, and if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua is telling, his brother, he said, choose today who you're going to serve. Either you're going to serve the God of the Egyptian that our father served, or you're going to serve the God of the Amorite in the land where we are dwelling. But as for me and my wife, as for me and my family, as for me and my children, as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord God. Children of God, your decision is very crucial. You are the one. You are the one because you're going to be accountable of the decision that you are making. He said, me and my house, we will serve the Lord God. Children of God, your decision, you are the one who decide your fate. Nobody will decide for you. When you are a child, yes, somebody will decide for you. Me and my wife, we decide to move. And we are moving, so we decide our children, they just follow us. They end up where we are leading them. But when you grow up, you make decision. You decide your fate. So children of God, decision you are making every single day. But make the wise decision. Number one, know your destiny. Know where you are going. It will help you make wise decision. And know that the decision you are making will decide your fate. Will decide whether you're going to spend eternity in heaven or you're going to spend eternity in hell. So you decide, children of God. Number three, your decision will determine what you get. Your decision will determine what you get in this life. Now let's read here, Matthew 27:15-17. Matthew 27:15-17. You know, some of us, we spend a lot of time making decisions which does not really matter. Spending 1 hour, 2 hours just to decide which dress are you going to wear. Come on. Spending 1 hour, which color, which makeup. And by this time, we are all wearing masks, but you are still thinking about makeup, volcanic makeup. Come on. You have major decision. And sometimes we take those decisions lightly when it comes to your marriage, when it comes to your job, when it comes to your calling, when it comes to your tomorrow. We take them lightly. We take them lightly. And we pay dearly. We pay dearly. Children of God, you only have one life. Only one life that the Lord God gave you. Only one life, not two. So be serious about your life. The way some of us we are living is as if that we don't have is a life without meaning. A life without purpose. We take our life lightly is a gift from the Lord God that we should cherish and know that we're going to be accountable for every word, every action, every decision, every choice. We will be accountable. Now, children of God, look at this example here, Matthew 27, verse 15 to 17. Matthew 27. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We say that your decision determines what you get in this life. Matthew 27, verse 15. Verse 15 to 17. Thank you, Jesus. Look here. Now at that feast, the governor was want to release unto the people a prisoner whom they would. And they had then a notable prisoner called Barabbas. Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, whom will ye that I release unto you? Barabbas or Jesus, which is called Christ? Now, children of God, the governor always releases a prisoner. Now, the governor had Jesus and Barabbas. And he came to the people. He said, which one do you want me to release unto you? Barabbas or Jesus called Christ? Now, people, they have to choose. And guess what? The governor was telling them, you want me to release Barabbas unto you? The criminal? The one who raped your children? The one who was stealing your chicken? The one who stole your Louboutin? The one who murdered your people? You want me to release him? Or you want me to release Jesus? The one who feed you with fish and bread. The one who rose Lazarus from the dead. The one who healed the sick. The one who opened blind eyes. The one who healed the paralytic. Which one do you want? Which one do you want? You will think that the people will choose Jesus. No, but they made a decision. They said, we want Barabbas. He said, are you sure you really want him? We want him. And this is how we behave. Now look here. We are three in one, flesh and spirit. The flesh wants to drive your life. And the spirit wants to drive your life. The spirit is the one who's supposed to drive your life. We walk by faith and not by sight. Walk in the spirit. So when the Holy Spirit communicates, when the Holy Spirit communicates with your spirit and light your spirit, then your spirit should lead you. But the flesh also wants to lead you. Now, Barabbas represents the flesh, the will of the flesh. And we know the will of the flesh. The flesh wants to do what? Sin. And Jesus represents the will of God. Remember when Jesus said, Father, if this cup has to pass before me, nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. Now, children of God, you get what you choose. You get what you decide. That's what you get. And some of us, when it comes even to marriage, even when they told you, look at this one, is irresponsible. Look at this one, it will not take care of you. Look at this one, the way he behave, look at him. You even get upset. Are you God? Are you God? Do you know it's tomorrow? And look at this Jesus. He already proved himself. Look at the resume of this Jesus. And you don't know. The Bible says the first will be last and the last will be. So you think that Jesus will be the last? Children of God, look how people decide. Look how people decide. And notice, I want to notice, when you decide according to the flesh, you get evil results. Look what the Bible says here in the book of Galatians. Look what the Bible says here. So you get the result, evil result. Galatians 5. Look, Galatians 5, verse 19 to 21. Galatians 5, 19 to 21. When you choose Barabbas, what the Bible says here, Galatians 5, 19, it says, now the works of the flesh are manifest. Which are these? When you choose, you get what you decide. Now, when you decide according to the flesh, this is what you get. Number one, you get what? Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, sedition, heresy, envying, murder, drunkenness, reviling, and such like. Of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. If you do these things, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. Why? Because of decision according to the flesh. Decision according to the flesh. These are the results you get, children of God. But when you take decision, you choose Jesus, means that you are choosing the will of God. Now look what you get. Verse 22 to 23. He said what? But the fruit of the Spirit is what? Love. This is what love. This is what you get. When you choose according to the Spirit, what you get? Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. This is what you get. So, children of God, your decision determines what you get. You make a good decision, you get blessing, you get life. You make the wrong decision, you get curses, you get frustration in your life. And many of us, today we are living with the consequence of our decision. You can even look in the eyes of that consequence. Why? Because you chose Barabbas. You chose Barabbas instead of choosing Jesus. Look at your life today. What you have today is the decision that you made yesterday. And today, and you know, sometimes when we make decision, you're not going to see the consequences right away. That's what the Bible says, a way must seem right to a man, but the end of it is what? Is death. So when you are making those decisions, you are so happy, you are so excited, but you don't know the end of it. I know people who made decisions. But go and see them today if they are enjoying. Go and see them today if they experience joy, if they experience peace, if they experience the fruit of the Spirit in those decisions they made. Or if they are suffering, they are crying today. Children of God, it's good to suffer today than to suffer for the rest of your life. Make a wise decision. Make a wise decision. In all your ways, acknowledge the Lord God. He knows better than you. He knows your tomorrow better than you. And some of us, now you receive what you have is because of the decision you made. Now it's hard for you to deal with them. And you know, some of us, we just wait, you know, for somebody else to decide for you. No, nobody will decide for you. Nobody will decide for you. People might give you advice, but you are the one who make a decision. Now, children of God, number four, decision can limit you. Decision can limit you. In this life, you know, sometimes you made already a decision, and because of the decision that you made, It will determine how you respond, how you react to certain situations, how you react to certain people. So the decision can limit you. And some of us, you already make decision. You know, especially before you get married. I want him tall like Pastor Ghislain. I want him like this with broad shoulder. I want him with muscle, six pack. Unfortunately, to nail all the fitness, they are close. So I want him like this. I want him like this. So you made already a decision. I want her light skin. I want her with frizz hair, curl hair, so my baby will look. So we made already a decision. And now, when what comes to you is contrary to the decision you already made, you are limited. You cannot go behind your decision. You cannot move behind your decision. Decision limits you. And some of us, you decided, okay, me when it comes, nobody, everybody is not made for school. You already made that decision. Even if you have opportunity to go to school, you're not going to go to school. And some of us, we already decided, and the decision that we made, we are now prisoner of those decisions. And the way now we interact with people, the way now we react to certain events is because we already made a decision. And you don't want to change. You don't want to change. You know, some of the people, for example, everybody knows that your wife cheats. The husband knows that your wife cheats. The neighbor, everybody knows. You are the only one who don't know. And because you already made such decision not to let her go or not to let him go, you become prisoner of that decision. And here, that's why you hear most of the time people, they will say, I will take this decision. I will break this relationship. Then the next day when you ask him or you ask her, so how about that relationship? Oh, girl, you know, God came to me last night, and then I saw the fire. So it was like God was telling me that I'm going to go to hell, that I need to forgive. No. He's prisoner or she's prisoner of their own decision. Children of God, in this life, it comes time that you have to make tough decision. Life is not easy. Life is not easy. You know, it's easy to criticize people, for example, to criticize a president, to criticize somebody who is in the highest position, because you are not sitting in that chair. When you sit in that chair, you feel the heat, then you will know that it's not easy to make decision. Right now, all of us, we want to stay home and get paid. So when the company said that we are making decision, we cannot close, all of us, we get upset. They have a lot of money. Why they don't just close the company? As if it's easy. On one hand, you want to stay home. On the other hand, you want to be paid. Where you want the money to come from? Some decision in life is not like 1 + 1 = 2. No. Tough decision. So children of God, they limit you. You can read the book of Acts 4, 21 to 22. Acts 4, 21 to 22. So, children of God, Acts 1, Acts chapter 4. Let's read here. Acts chapter 4, verse 21 to 22. Look what the Bible says here. So when they had further threatened them, Peter and John, they let them go, finding nothing. They could not decide, finding nothing how they might punish them because of the people. For all men glorify God for that which was done. For the man was above 40 years old, on whom this miracle of healing was shown. Now, these people, they did not want the disciple to talk about Jesus. They did not want to hear about the gospel. But after they performed signs and wonders, they could not hide. So this man was over 40 years old, so they could not hide. But they already made the decision that we should put them to jail, we should shut them down. They already decide. So that decision already limits them. So they say that we're going to do this. But because of the people, they glorified the Lord God, it was hard for them to hide. So they did not have any other choice. Children of God, decision can limit you. Decision can limit you. And you don't go further. You don't move forward. But let those decisions be made in the light of the word of God. Look at your life today. At the things that you could have done for your life. The good things that you could have done. Why? Because of some decision that you made. I will never do this. And today you suffer because of those decisions. And to undo them is hard for you. So children of God, your decision. That's why in this life, you have to learn to make tough decisions. I used to have a professor who used to say, 5 minutes of pleasure, 9 months of pregnancy, and one child for life. Is to let us know that don't take your life lightly. You don't live for people. You are living for yourself. It's your own life. You are responsible for that life. Don't make decisions to please people. You are never going to please people. Please your maker. Please your God. Because you are accountable to him, not to people. People might help you, but you are the decision maker. And make decision according to the word of God. Make decision in the light of the word of God. Don't make decision just to please people, to please yourself. You will regret. How many people regret today? Because of the decision they made. And they want to blame others. If I am like this, it's because of my pastor. If I am like this, it's because of my father. If I'm like this, it's because of my mother. Never because of you. Never because of you. I decide to live this way. Because I see the way my father is living. Your father will be accountable of his act before the Lord God. You will not sit upon that throne and say, God, I did this because my mother used to be. I did not. Base your decision. Let your decision be based according to the word of God. According to the word of God. Children of God, because we are being influenced by example, by people. And that's why you will notice that our parents, they are tough with, especially we born in the family, if you are among the older, you receive tough education. Discipline. When we look at our young brother, young sister, we say, oh, daddy is too old. Mommy is too old. In our time, you cannot get away with murder. Then this generation of today, Why? Because the parent, they want the next generation to learn from the elder. But look at the elder, the type of decision we are making. Because your decision will affect not only you, it will affect a lot of people. Jesus is our role model. So the way Jesus was making decisions, that's how we should make decisions. We have the nature of God. We cannot be Christ, but we are Christian. We are Christ-like. So the decision that you are making, tough decision, you get what you decide. You get what you decide. Either you get life or either you get death. And you deal with it. Children of God, be responsible for your life. And then number five, decision making requires facts. We're going to read Acts 24, 22 to 23. Look what the Bible says here. And when Felix heard these things, having more perfect knowledge of that way, he deferred them and said, when Lysias, the chief captain, shall come down, I will know the uttermost of your matter. And he commanded a centurion to keep Paul and to let him have liberty, and that he should forbid none of his acquaintance to minister or to come unto him. You see, you make a decision when you have sufficient information. Make sure you have sufficient information before making decision. Read. Do some research. Consult. And pray before making decision. But I notice some of the people, they don't want to read. They don't want to do some research. And the counsel they want the counsel that goes in their favor. Children of God, you don't do yourself favor when you go seek advice, but the way you paint the problem, you paint in a such a way that when people give you advice, that advice will favor you. So that later on, when you will face consequences, you will come and say, my father, my mother, my brother, my sister, even the pastor, they advised me this. Yes, because the way you presented the fact, the way you presented the problem, everybody will advise you the same way. But this is what you want. You want people to advise you, and you want that advice to favor you. So you come, you paint the problem, you paint the picture, so it will turn into your favor. You don't do yourself no good. Because when problem will rise and you go back to the people, they will say, if I knew what I know now, I will never advise you that way. Yeah, but you told me, I told you because the way you presented your case, children of God, and this is what we do. You are living already with Ghislain 1 and you are living with Ghislain 2. Then you go before the Lord God. Deep in your heart, you want Ghislain 1. And then you go before God. God, is it Ghislain 1 or Ghislain 2? As if God told you Ghislain 2, you will go with Ghislain 2. Because I know when they tell you Ghislain 2, then you're gonna come. Yeah, you think that Ghislain 2 is Jesus. No, that the Barabbas. The one that you think that is Jesus, that the Barabbas. And the one that you think is Barabbas, that Jesus. Because you already made up your mind. And you will notice that people who don't want to hear, anytime you advise them, always come with something. Anytime you advise them, look, this one is Barabbas. Yes, you know, Barabbas, yeah, he stole the chicken because that day they did not leave food for him. Okay. But this one is a murder. Yeah, he murdered because they broke his heart. Always you will find excuses. Guess what? God will let you. He said, go. Go find with your Barabbas. Children of God, you have to have all the facts. And some of us, even when you have all the facts, you still make the wrong decision. You have all the facts, you still make the wrong decision. Are you God? Do you know the tomorrow? So why you come to ask for advice? Now he does not favor you, you are upset. So children of God, you need to have all the facts. Look at this Felix. He said, okay, let me have all the facts. So the next time I will deal with you, I will have already all the information that I need. Children of God, you need all the information that you need to make that decision. All the information required before you make that decision. Don't just throw yourself into marriage without knowledge. Don't just throw yourself in business without knowledge. Don't just throw yourself in the ministry without knowledge, without information. Otherwise, you are doomed to fail. You will fail. Don't take your life lightly. So, children of God, number six. Undecided people never make a move. Undecided people never make a move. They never get started. The reason why your marriage is full of trouble is because you're still undecided. The reason things are not working in your life is because you're still undecided. And people, you might think that only wrong decision is a major problem. No, for some of us, indecision is a major problem. Some folks, it's hard for them to make decision. Children of God, redeem the time. We are not going to live here on earth for eternity. You don't know the tomorrow. Indecision. So things are the way they are because of indecision. You have to be able to decide. Are you going to continue in that relationship? Knowing that relationship does not glorify the Lord God. Are you going to continue in the things that you are doing? The life that you are living, a life of unforgiveness, a life of hatred, a life of false accusation, a life of discouragement, a life of deception, a life of going nowhere. Are you going to continue to just see? You see that your marriage is dying. You see that your family is dying. But here you are, undecided. Children of God, make a decision today. Make a decision today. Don't be like the rich man in the Bible. God, let me go out so I can talk to my people so they will not come where I am today. God said, no, I have plenty of people over there. Some of us, we know that the place where we are going, we don't receive the word of God. We know the word of God. We know. I remember in my early age in the ministry, I was doing Bible study. It was every Thursday, somebody came, old man, older than me. Never seen the man before. And the man was there. I remember that day, I was preaching on the Holy Spirit. teaching on the Holy Spirit. The man was there. The man was just asking question after question. I thought he came just for me. He was in my early age. And I was teaching. I teach for 1 hour, more than an hour, about the Holy Spirit. Then later on, the man came to me. And he said, "Pastor, do you know my age?" I said, "I don't know. I'm way older than you. Every single thing, just you thought about the Holy Spirit, is the truth. Every single thing, you answer to all my questions. Every single thing is the truth. But look, I'm a Jehovah Witness. I've been Jehovah Witness for more than 30 years. Not even your age, Pastor. You think that I just gonna turn my more than 30 years, throw it by the window just because you convince me about the Holy Spirit? No way. I can't. It's tough." But look, children of God, he admit himself that every single thing he received about the Holy Spirit, it was the truth. But because you already made that decision, you see how decision can limit you? Because you already made that decision, you know, some of us, "I was born Catholic, I will die Catholic," as if Catholic is the one who's going to answer. Jesus did not die for any religion. He did not die for any religion. He did not even bring any religion. When we're going to sit over there, God, we're not going to ask you, "Were you Pentecostal? Were you Jehovah Witness? Were you?" No. Go a place where you will receive the word of God. Don't be at the place where you doubt. And some of us, you might be in the wrong place. I don't just talk about Catholics. You might go to some pastor too. They don't teach the word of God. They entertain you. They just want your money, your offering. And now that they know that you have the stimulus, they will come with those type of nonsense so they can get also your stimulus. But you know any better? "I was born Catholic, I will die Catholic." And you think that when you say these things, that God will be pleased. God will put his hand together for you. No. Make tough decision. Make tough decision. You know, when I was growing up, when I start to know really Christ, I start going to Pentecostal church. One lady, it was a Bible study, and that was my first experience. And the lady was asking the pastor, "Pastor, you know, I'm a Christian. I come to your church. But my husband, he loves to drink. So if he sends me to buy beer, should I go?" I was, wow, I never experienced this in the church. And the pastor was struggling with the question, and the pastor was telling her, "You know, pray to God and tell your husband that you are a Christian. You cannot go buy beer for him." He said, "But my husband beat me. What should I do?" And you, on one side, you say we should be submissive. And on the other side, what should I do? I listened to the pastor, how he was struggling, not knowing that one day I'll become pastor. Children of God, now that I'm pastor, now that I know the word of God, now that I know that you are responsible, if I'm the wife, you send me to buy Corona for you, tequila, I will buy vodka for you. Yes, I will buy vodka for you, because you will not drink with my mouth. It will not go into my stomach, my belly. It will go into your own mouth. It's your own decision. And you know, when things happen, they always blame the woman. They will come, "How come this a Christian woman? She knows God. How come she gonna let her husband drink to death? How come she gonna let the husband and she gonna go buy? Why your son cannot make a right choice, a right decision, and knowing what is good for him and what is not good for him?" We have to blame the woman. Children of God, you are responsible for your own action. And that's why we have this saying, you can bring a camel to the water, but you're not going to force the camel to drink water. I can bring you vodka, but I'm not going to force you to drink. It's your own decision. So children of God, people are undecided. Why are you undecided? Make a decision today. Make a decision today. Are we forgive people? Make a phone call. And some of you, I know, you make a phone call. Hi, sweetheart. Don't think anything else. I just call you because pastor said, pastor did not say anything. Let it be come from your heart. Let it come from heart. Why are we always like that? And pastor preach a bar. You know, if it wasn't for pastor, how would I call you? No. It's not pastor. It's the Holy Spirit. Make a decision. You hear the word of God day after day. Make a decision that I will live right. Life of righteousness, life of holiness, life of following and obey the commandment of the Lord God. I'm gonna win soul for Christ. Children of God, make a decision. You know, some men, even they receive from God. You can receive even in the dream, and God show you in the dream, this is the woman of your life. But make a decision. Here you are, you just see the woman say, this is the woman of my life. God show me in the dream. So what is next? What is next? Make a move. Make a decision. We are undecided and we keep on praying. God put the blessing on the table. Go and take it. You already pray for the blessing and God put on the table. Make a decision to go and take it. You are still praying. You are like this man who did not eat for weeks. Then they present him food. They take him to Chinese buffet. not Chinese. No. They take him to a buffet. And then he see food. And the man say, I believe if I eat this food, I will not die. I believe if I eat this food, I will gain strength. I believe if I eat this food, oh, I will be strong like never before. I believe until the man died. He keep believing, keep believing. Action. Hallelujah. So children of God, don't remain undecided. Look what the Bible say in the book of Joel. Joel 3 verse 14. See, this is the problem. Make a decision. People are undecided. I didn't decide yet. When are you going to decide? Tomorrow? Are you sure that you're going to be there tomorrow? Redeem the time. Oh, I'm still taking my time. Are you God? Time is not in your hand. It's in the hand of God. And you hear most of the time people say, I'm taking my time. They don't want to take decision. They are not pleased with what presents to them. They are not pleased with what presents to them. When they say, I'm not ready to take decision yet, they took the decision. But they are afraid to express that decision because they know that people say, you do that the decision. So since they want to please you and since they don't want to hear that, this is the way they say, I didn't decide yet. Meanwhile, they already decide. And the decision that they made, that what limits them. Oh, no, you know, I didn't decide yet. You know, God is speaking to me this time. You will never pray. You will never live by the word of God. Suddenly, God starts speaking to you. When he comes to make that decision, oh, you know, God is speaking to me, and I feel this day, I keep seeing the fire. So, you know, maybe it's hell. God is showing me hell. That's why I don't want to take the... No, don't lie to people. You know, you can lie to people, but you cannot lie to yourself. And we always want to lie on God. God told me. No, it's not God. It's you. You want to please yourself. You want to choose Barabbas. And because you want to choose Barabbas, you're going to come with many explanations. Try to justify that this Barabbas is not really Barabbas, it's Jesus. And we all know it's Barabbas. Make tough decisions in your life. A man or a woman is the one who makes tough decisions. When it hurts, when you cry, Father, not my will, but your will. Not my will, but your will. I know my purpose. How many suffer today because of the decision, bad decision? How many suffer today because of indecision in their life? Here you are, you cry. I should have taken that decision. Why I did not take that decision? Now your life is full of regret. Or maybe why did I take that decision? Children of God, in this life, we have only three stages. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Your yesterday is gone. You are living your today. And your today is the decision of your yesterday. And your tomorrow is the decision of today. Your life is in three seasons, man, morning season, afternoon season, and night season. If you took wrong decision in your morning season, you will deal with the consequences of it in your afternoon season. And your afternoon season is not going to be for enjoyment, it's going to be for endurement. Your morning season, from when you come from your mother's home, you're crying, yeah, to 30 years old. Your afternoon, from 31 to 60. And your night season, from 61 to wherever God gonna call you, when you say bye-bye. If your morning season, you decided, school is not for me. Obey my parents is not for me. They are too old. They are old-fashioned. I can live the way I want to live. Get pregnant, getting children everywhere, and living the type of life that you want. Trust me, in your afternoon season, you will pay. You will pay. It's not easy to be married when you have children around you. Then you want to force the other husband, the one that you're going to find, to love the children, to love your mistakes. Children of God, life is decision. Make decision. Make the right decision. And some of it, so now you start blaming God. Don't blame God. We are the one who say, is my life. I can do whatever I want to do. It's my life. Now deal with the decision. Deal with the consequence of it. And decision. And some we cannot make decision. We are afraid of making decision. Meanwhile, God already revealed to you. God already spoke unto you. Look what the Bible says. I know today I can be a little bit long, but look what the Bible says here. Joel 3:14. Look what the Bible says here. You see what? Multitudes in the valley of decision. For the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. Many people find themselves in the valley of decision. Why do you don't want to get a car? Why you don't want to get a job? Oh, I need to buy first a car. For me to get a job. Really? Why we don't want to, when I will be married, then I will start my ministry. When I will have the first child, then I will do this. So you still undecided because you have the if and if and if and if in your life. When is the time that is going to be the right time for you? To make a decision. Make a decision now. You know that relationship is not taking you anywhere. You know that position is not taking you anywhere. You know what you are doing is not moving you forward. Take a decision. So, children of God, undecided people. Number seven, decision binds people and make them do the impossible and the unthinkable. Decision binds people and make them do the impossible and unthinkable. Look here, Matthew 27. Look what the Bible says here, Matthew 27, 1 to 2. When the morning was come, all the chief priests and elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. So all of them, the priests, the elder, they decided to put Jesus to death. And when they had bound him, they led him away and delivered him unto Pontius Pilate, the governor. You know, decision bind people. Decision bind people. It might be a good decision. It might be bad decision. That's why you see people who make the same type of decision, they're always together. It binds them. It binds them. And they can do the unthinkable. All of them, because of the hatred, they hate so much Jesus. He bound them together. Children of God. Number eight, general opinion does not have to be your opinion. General opinion does not have to be your opinion. And you know, all of us, when we're growing up, when you do something, I don't want to, why you think you are going wearing this thing? This short skirt. Oh, mommy, all my friends are going to wear this. You remember? All my people are going to do this. All my friends are going to do this. All my people, everybody is doing it. You are not everybody. And I always say, you know, everybody do this. Okay. If everybody start walking naked down the street, are you going to walk naked down the street? Oh, no, Pastor, I can't do that. Okay, if you can't do that, why you have to do others? Why you have to follow others? It shows that you don't have personality. It shows that you don't have personality. It's not because everybody is doing it that you have to do it. Everybody has a sagging pant. You too, you have to have a sagging pant. As if we want to see your butt. Thank God in another state they give you even ticket for that. Everybody is doing it that you have to do. If it's beneficial, yes. If it's in line, yes. But if it's out of line, why you have to do them? And our parents, they always tell you, you are not everybody, you are my child. You do whatever I ask you to do. Because the last time I checked, you don't pay any bills in this house. I'm still paying. Everybody is doing it. But you're not everybody. So general opinion does not have to be your opinion. It's not because everybody said it that make it right. It's not because everybody said it and make it right. No. Let the whole world say it, but if it's not what God say, it's not right. Look what the Bible say here. Luke 23. You know, people they love to follow. Everybody doing it on Facebook. Everybody doing it. You are not everybody. For once, be you. For once, be you. If people bleach, you will bleach too. Everybody bleach. People touch the nose, you touch also your nose. Everybody do it. Be proud of who you are. You are wonderfully and fearfully made. Even if you are fearfully made, be proud. Look what the Bible says here, Luke 23. Luke 23:50. Luke 23:50. Really quick. Luke 23:50. I'm gonna finish this. Luke 23:50-54. Look what the Bible says here. Thank you, Jesus. He said, and behold, there was a man named Joseph, a counselor, and he was a good man and a just. The same had not consented to the counsel and the deeds of them. And he was of Arimathea, or America, a city of the Jew, who also himself waited for the kingdom of God. This man went unto Pilate and begged the body of Jesus, and he took it down and wrapped it in linen and laid in the sepulchre that was hewn in stone, wherein never man before was laid. And that day was the preparation, and the Sabbath drew on. See this man? He was not with the opinion. He was not with the elder, the priest, who hated Jesus and sacrificed Jesus. No. He stand out and went and begged for the body of Jesus and prepared and put Jesus. Every single thing Jesus has, he was borrowed, even the tomb. Children of God, you are not entitled. You are entitled to your own opinion. Stand on the truth. Stand on righteousness. Stand on holiness. Stand on the word of God. Stand on holiness. Stand on what is right. Let your decision be in line with the word of God. Always. Not because of what people are saying. It's like me, if I'm pastor, because I'm pastor today, I see all the pastor, they do first fruit, bring the first fruit. Me too, I have to follow. Hey, you guys, you need to bring the first fruit, and I'm going to bring some scripture for you so you can bring money, because everybody is doing it. Everybody say, you need to bring the tithe. Hey, me too, I have to follow them. No, you go by what the Lord God is saying. Children of God, go by what the Lord God is saying. Everybody, high heel, high heel. Look at your feet. Your feet cannot even fit in the high heel. Here you are, you force yourself. See the way you are walking. No monkey, don't even look at you. Now look here, number 9 to finish. Be determined to keep your decision. Be determined to keep your decision. Stand by your decision. Now, in this case, you stand by your decision when your decision is right. Stand by your decision, a right decision. You stand by it. Don't stand by a wrong decision. Don't die by the wrong decision. I already made it, so I cannot change it. Yes, you can change. But stand on the right decision. And look here. 2 Timothy, and bring it to an end. 2 Timothy 2:13. Because I wanted to finish this one. 2 Timothy is very crucial. Make the right decision, children of God. Make the right decision. Make the right decision. 2 Timothy chapter 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13. Look what the Bible says here. If we believe not, yet he abide faithful, he cannot deny himself. Even if we are not faithful, God is still faithful. He cannot deny himself. It's a decision. So remain faithful to your decision. Remain faithful to your decision. When is the right decision? Stand by it. As your decision to accept Jesus as your Lord and Christ, as your Lord and Savior, you stand by it. Stand by it. Once you know it's the word of God, you stand by it. But a wrong decision, mistake, you can come out of it. You can change it. Because your life calls you for a better tomorrow, a better future. You can change. You can change. When you make a vow to God, stand by it. When you accept Jesus, stand by that decision. Every good decision, every decision you made in the light of the word of God, be resolute, children of God. Everything starts with a decision. Make a right decision. A decision will move you close to your dream, or a decision can move you far away from it. And the will is the faculty of the soul where choices and decisions are made. So it influences and controls the human mind. That's what the Bible says, renew your mind. Don't be conformed to this world, but renew your mind. If your thoughts are wrong, your choice will be wrong. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Every decision you made is because you thought already about it. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Renew your mind. Children of God, your perception, your interpretation, if it's wrong, surely your choice will be wrong. Change the way you think so that you can make a better decision. Please make a decision today. If this message has been a blessing unto you, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and share also the video so others can be also blessed. May the Lord God richly bless you. Amen.